that you are Palestinian.
Sure.
And this is ancient Hebrew.
Sure, yeah, I know that.
And you can read the ancient Samaritan Hebrew.
No, sure, sure.
Oh.
They are my friends. I know a little bit about the Arabic language, the Aramaic. You know,
Aramaic.
The old Hebrew
yes.
language is written, they believe that it's the Torah written in this language. It means, you know, it's like something like the beginning of the Quran. We have the same Fatiha, the same idea of the Fatiha. In the Samaritan sect religion.
Ah, so this is called Aramaic or ancient
Hebrew? Old Hebrew. Ancient Hebrew.
Is called Aramaic.
So they have these letters is older than the new Hebrew letters.
Yes.
You can see this bet, bet, sheen, mean, shema. You'd have vav, vav is vav.
Yes.
The accent is different from the new Hebrew.
Uh-huh.
So when you hear it, you feel that it's different from the new Hebrew. And the pronunciation of the letters is different.
Yes.
This is vav in Hebrew. It's vav in the Samaritan language. They don't pronounce the letter eh. Or eh, it's eat.
Uh-huh.
So there's difference in the accent.
Uh-huh.
They use Tergum, it's other languages used in the past one also. But this is the Torah language, the Bible language, which is for the five books of Moses.
Yes, the five books of Moses. And this is an Aramaic.
Sure.
Okay, but I thought Aramaic was after Hebrew.
I don't know the three of the languages, you know. They have only, I believe that they have origin for these all languages. Maybe the Aramaic is the origin of the Arabic, Hebrew, maybe also, you know, there's accent also in Aramaic language. The Syrian, or the Syriac language, also they use Aramaic, but in different vowels and accents, and different letters. This is the Samaritans, they have the Torah, they have, maybe after Aaron, the son of Aaron who write this copy of Torah, they use the same letters. So at least the language of the Torah is this language and this letter, as they believe.
So the language of the Torah uses Aramaic letters? These are Aramaic letters.
Ancient Hebrew, you know.
So they're mixed, mixed.
Yeah.
Ah, they existed at the same time.
Yeah.
And used at the same time.
Some people believe that it's old Hebrew, you know. Some people believe that it's kind of Aramaic accents. Aramaic accents. At least most people believe that it's the oldest copy of the Torah is the copy which they have the Samaritan.
Yeah, the most original, yes.
The most original one.
Yeah, before Ezra's version.
You know, that there's many differences between the Jews.
Oh,
the
many,
Jews.
Many, yeah.
And as you know, maybe you
the Ezra Torah has very big problems with
at
it.
At least the orientation. Here, they are facing the Mount Gerizim, and Jews believe or facing Moriah and Jerusalem.
Ah, yes.
The difference in the main. Doctrine or ideology, the yes. difference between Samaritans and Jews. Even they both of them believe in Moses and one God, Elohim, or
yes.
believe in Torah and believe in at least the first five books.
Yes. I read also that there used to be a Jewish temple on Mount Gerizim that was destroyed by the Jews who returned from Babylon. There was a temple here before.
Maybe Jews say that, but the archaeological artifacts on Mount Gerizim, they find most of the artifacts there are for the Samaritans because they were in the past, they believe that they were staying here. They don't go out of Palestine.
No, they stay,
here,
yes.
They stay here. Mm-hmm. So they believe that they, you know, Kiryat Luz, which is Luz, the old Luz, which is the old village on Mount Gerizim, where the Samaritans live there. They did that to stay on the site there, and you know they have Shechem east of Nablus, and then they moved to Nablus, which is the new Nablus, the new city now, and they have their own neighborhood. Then after the earthquake, 1927, they have the new neighborhood out of the old city. Then they moved 1994 to Mount Gerizim, their holy mountain.
I see.
So they have many sites who live, and they were living in Egypt, Syria, but before 200 or 300 years, they became minorities in the whole world, so they came and lived together. the five families of the Samaritans, they were brought from all the Arab countries and live in Palestine here in Nablus.
Ah, very good. Thank you so much.
You are welcome, friend. Nice to meet you.